Santi, that three-pointer you made with the foul, just kind of what's going through your mind there when you're watching that ball fall?
To be honest, I didn't see it fall. I was already on the ground when it went in, so I guessed by the way everybody yelled. But in that play, to be honest, it's just you can't think at that point. It's a thing that if you're missing, you got to stay confident. I'm confident in all of my teammates taking any shot, and I know they're confident in me. And even coach told me, like, just keep shooting. They're going to fall at some point. And that's the thing you can't lose as a shooter is confidence. And any open look that you can get, you got to shoot it. And lucky for us, that one went in, even with a foul.
Santi, Josiah kind of talked about it, but why were you guys today able to keep the defensive intensity up compared to how you weren't at Florida when the shots weren't falling?
I think as a team, we did a great job just guarding, putting everything on the line. We knew how big of a game it was for us, especially as a bounce back game. And I heard Joe earlier talking about it. It shows a lot of character from the whole team. I think that's what the team showed tonight or today, that even if shots aren't going in, we're not going to give up. We're going to still keep playing. And I think overall it's just a poor shooting night for both of the teams. So, just stay on the game, stay locked in and give everything, and we never gave up.
There was a play pretty early in the game where Tobe got a rebound, got fouled, and kind of came up jawing at the guy who fouled him. He obviously doesn't show a lot of emotion typically. What was it like seeing that from him early in the game?
To be honest, we're so into the game that I can't even remember that one. But so you say he got a rebound?
Yeah, he got fouled, and he kind of started jawing and talking at the guy who fouled him in front of the Tennessee coach. Yeah, we typically don't see him talking to the other team.
Well,
showing that emotion.
Now I know what you're talking about. I think that shows even more character, especially him as a freshman. He's a very quiet guy, but he's not going to let nobody step on top of him. And, yeah, as a player, you always get those moments where you just get sick of other people beating you up. And especially for him, he's done a great job down there in the paint. There's most of the times you guys don't see it, but we know we can throw a shot up. And he's going to go get it. He's battling 24/7 every night. Good for him that he stood up. And he was, like, not going to let that just step over him. So I think it shows a lot of character from him.
Santiago, I guess last year you had a similar type game against Texas Tech where the shots just weren't falling. But there were 88 missed shots today. When, as a shooter, what's that like to go through a game like this?
To be honest, we have a lot of confidence on our defense. We know even if we're not making shots, that's something coach says all the time. We're confident that if we play defense and we rebound the ball, that's where our main focus is. We're going to be able to create enough points to win a game. So as a shooter, you just have a short-term memory. You can't be thinking about all the shots that you missed or if you went 0 for 5 over 6 or whatever you went for. You just can't be thinking about that. You got to think about the next shot and think that it's going to go in, because if not, then you just get in a hole. I had that conversation with a couple of our guys. You just can't be thinking back to that. You got to think about the next shot, and if you're open, you have to take it. We all expect you to take it. They all expect me to take it, so that's what we have to do every time we're open.
What's it say about Josiah in a game like this to get 15 and 14 for him to just play that huge of a role?
I mean, he does everything. I love being with Joe on the court. I think he's a guy that his IQ, most of the people don't see it either, but his IQ is really, really high. I feel really confident when he's on the floor. Just especially, first of all, on defense with him. I think when he's in the court with all the guys, we have a great connection. You know, we can talk, and he's a smart guy. Even on switches or whatever it might be, he's going to fix the play. And then I'm glad for him that today the ball went in. He made a lot of shots. And then he's a big dude. You can see him. And then he's going to fight every time down on the board. And he did a great job tonight coming out with those boards. I think it was big for us in the game.
Santi in the back here. I think at the 11-minute mark, you were starting to play point guard. I know you played a little bit point guard when you first got here, but how much have you played point guard this season, and how much have you actually practiced it since you first got here?
Not so much. I've been more of a shooting guard. Kind of my time here in Tennessee, I kind of developed more into a shooting guard than a point guard. I don't know if I'm supposed to say this or not. I don't think it's a big deal. Tyreek kind of twisted his ankle last practice, so I did go in a little bit for as a point guard. We were doing 5-on-5, and then we were doing run rep with C, and I was taking the other rep as a point guard, so I kind of got a little more of a feel of what it is. And I'm really confident, even if I'm not the point guard, if I'm the shooting guard, I'm really confident in Tyreek, Sakai, or even Josiah brought the ball up today. I think it was great for us. He just waved me, told me, just go, I got it. And I think that's great. Having the possibility to have all the other guys, even the big man, just to get the rebound and bring the ball up, it's going to make us even more lethal.
Anything else for Santi? Finish up with Wes.
Santi, y'all have played some games like this the past couple of years, obviously. There were three or four of them last year. There were a few this year. And y'all have lost most of those games. And nice is it to win one of these, you know, one of these games like in the 50s or 40s and sort of gut one out?
What was the question?
Just in terms of how y'all played a lot of games like this, a few games the last few years, games in the 50s and the 40s. A lot of those were tough losses. To win one like this, how big is that for this team to sort of get past that?
It's definitely a big win. It shows how much character we can have, and just we got to keep pushing even if we don't make the ball. So, like I said earlier, it's just like what Joe said. It shows a lot of our character from our team.
All right, Santi, thank you very much.
Thank you.